Welcome back to the Leadership Series, guys. Today we have Jitendra Choksi, who calls himself an accidental entrepreneur. And you know, I also discovered him accidentally on my LinkedIn, and ever since I was very amused. Jitendra, I think you're one of the few startups who've raised funding during the lockdown, 2 billion. So how has been the journey?
The journey was amazing. So far everything that we have done in the last six and a half years, both as a community and the last 5 years as a company, I think the journey has been phenomenal. It has definitely changed my perspective on life, on pretty much everything. You know, I was a different guy before this happened. I'm a completely different person after this. So definitely a lot has happened.
Just tell me, I know I've read about you also, of course, you know, that how you started, you've gone through the journey. But it's always difficult to raise funding, right? Because in today's time, in our country, we also do a lot of startup events. I've been a startup founder myself. So what were the hurdles which came through you, and what really pushed you?
I don't think funding is that big a deal. You know, whether you raise funds or not raise funds, you should never use that yardstick to evaluate your success. And you know that even before raising funds, we were pretty successful bootstrap, you know, doing a revenue of over 5 million ARR last year, right? So it wasn't that difficult for us. We have had offers before, which we had rejected because there was not the right philosophical fit. So basically for us, it was not that difficult. You often come across people who don't believe in your idea, who don't believe in your vision, but rather than taking that as a failure or a sign that your startup is not doing good, you have to understand that people are usually not looking for what you are looking for, right? So it's just a matter of time, and build a solid unit economics, build a business which is profitable. And like people always say, your customers are your first set of investors. So just make sure that whatever you're doing, you're solving problem for your customers. Mm-hmm. And as long as you continue to do that, you know, any investor who sees that there is growth potential, they will come on board.
Like, what is the one trick you believe on, but which most people disagree on?
I'm not a guy who unnecessarily attaches itself to something, just for the sake of it. I'm a logical guy. I weigh in everybody's opinion. So I don't think there is any one truth that is just that I believe in. I think there's a lot of things which I believe in. Believed in, changed my opinion, will continue changing. So I don't think there is any such thing.
What is the one subject you think that all aspiring leaders and startup founders like you should always stick on, like should have a very hardcore belief on? Of course, you said about your own vision, but what are the, you know, one, two qualities that you think that's really is the word, right?
If I have to suggest somebody to pay attention to, I think pay attention to your physical and mental health. And you'd realize that, you know, if you are able to control your physical and mental health, you can achieve anything in life. And so just that one subject, I'd say, is, you know, fitness and wellness. So just focus on that. If you're able to keep yourself, physically and mentally fit, there's nothing that you can't achieve.
Like they say, if you can't keep yourself in shape, how can you keep your company in shape?
I mean, yeah, touche.
Some, any leadership quotes that you live by, like which you keep referring to?
Yeah, so I have a lot of people who I look up to, especially Mahatma Gandhi. So, you know, all of his quotes are really amazing. When he talks about, losing yourself in the service of humanity, to find yourself, or, when he talks about how love is the greatest weapon, and you can conquer everything. So I believe in those things, everything which Mahatma Gandhi said, right? He's one of the guys who have inspired me throughout my life. And he's also a great philosopher. Like his learnings are really amazing. And once you understand the meaning behind those, teachings, you'd understand that him and Gautam Buddha said almost the same thing. Yeah. You know, they almost said the same thing. And once you understand those things, life gets much more comfortable, it gets much more easier, right? So I'm really inspired by everything that Mahatma Gandhi said. So if I'm in doubt, I just read one or two of his quotes, and that sorts out things.
And what has been your biggest learning in the pandemic? Like, everybody has gone through their own life cycle in the pandemic, you know?
Right. So look, I have always been a guy who never worked from home, right? So I think this is the longest I've worked from home in the last 8 months. This is the longest I've worked out from home in the last 8 months. So I realized that you can not only work at home, you can also work out at home, and you can excel both at work and workouts.
Any productivity apps that you use, or you know, any fitness apps that you, apart from Fitter, use, you know, or refer to?
I think Skype, Skype, Zoom, you know, these are some of the tools that we use for managing the whole team. And then GitHub, checking what people are doing, Jira. So these are some productivity tools that we use on a regular basis.
What are the next big plans that you're thinking of? Like, how do you plan to scale up?
We are already scaling up. The TAM is pretty big. There's 2.2 billion people globally who are in urgent need of fixing their lifestyle. Even in India, we look at our addressable market as north of 70 million people. So the idea is to reach out to as many people as we can and educate them about health and fitness. We are an education first company, right? So we don't sell any products. We don't sell any gimmicks. We don't have any fads. We address the two fundamental problems, which are the biggest roadblock in anybody's fitness journey. First, the low motivation that we solve through bringing in a community of people, right? So when people come together, they speak the same language, becomes easier for everybody to adopt fitness. Second thing is adherence, right? So we believe that most of the times people are not able to get fit because they start something and they are not able to continue on that. And the main reason for that is, you know, drastic changes that most of the products and gimmicks bring into their lives, right? So we fix that by making sure that there's no drastic changes. People are still living the life they want and getting fit by slowly changing their behavior, right? So behavioral change and low motivation, these are the problems that we are trying to solve.
So who would be your competition? Who would you rate like your immediate competition, next door competition, or the competition that you look up to both?
Well, technically, our competition is ourselves. You know, we look at whatever we have done in the past and we just want to improve our metrics better, because if we go out there and compare our metrics with our competitors, we realize that there's no competition really. You know, our NPS is 82, so we'd like to see it 85. You know, retention is 80% over 2 years. We'd like to see that 90%, right? So there are some things which we have done incredibly well, which is not the case with anybody else out there in the market today. And so we think of ourselves as our competitors. Whatever we have done till yesterday, we are going to do that, you know, better tomorrow. And that's how we think as a company, as a group, as a community.
Does your fit also, in a way, compete with you in some form?
Not really. Look, our key focus is always in solving a problem, right? And I see CureFit trying to solve something, but I'm not sure how effectively they are doing that, because you know, you compare metrics, you know, you compare outcomes, then you see what's the gap, what's the LTV, and when you compare those things, you realize that there is something fundamentally wrong with the business, right? And there is something fundamentally right in our case, right? So when the fundamentals are wrong, no matter how much capital you spend, you know, there will come a time when you will, basically it is not sustainable, right? So it's like anything in life. If the fundamentals are not strong, it's simply not sustainable, right? So in our case, we have focused absolutely on the fundamentals. You know, we were a growing business even before funding came. We are a growing business even after the funding came, right? So we focus on fundamentals. We focus on customer NPS as our North Star metric, right? We focus on results.
So, any plans of launching, you already said it, any plans of launching any fitness gadgets or something which complement your products in the future?
Look, that's not our expertise. You know, our expertise, our forte is educating people, and we'd like to continue focusing on that. We are a community. We provide a safe space for anybody without any sort of judgment to get indulged into fitness or ask questions, right? So we are an education first platform, and I think that is going to be always our core offering. We'll continue to democratize fitness. There might be a scenario where we would tie up with a company who is doing such thing, but we don't see any in current vicinity. I mean, we are discussing with Rohil Dev from Nemo Planet. They are coming up with smart glasses. So maybe you'd see something, you know, from us and Nemo Planet in future, but that's pretty much it.
Where do you see your consumption? Like, supposing if I have to go and join Fitter, so do I have to pay money or do I have to just, there's a freebie plus, what is the, how do you work like?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, except for the coaching services, everything is free of cost. You have enough articles, you have enough recipes, you have free diet and training plans, you also have calorie trackers, water reminders, diet tools, planners, and you have a community which is available to answer your questions 24/7. You have hundreds of thousands of transformations. So you can see from people's journey, and you'd be able to relate with them, right? So what happens once you join the community? You view other people's transformations, you get motivated, and then you have an option. Either you do it by yourself, if you are motivated enough, or you take help of a coach, which is when you actually end up paying us a small premium. But apart from that, everything is pretty much free in the community. We'd say roughly, you know, it's a split of 40-60. So 60% of our users are paid users, but there are 40% users who basically do it all for free.
So your revenue model would be only those 60% in the future, or is there any other revenue model that you're looking
at? Yeah.
And
in future, we'd introduce more premium services. Yeah.
Is it more from Android consumption or Apple? Like, your downloads are more on which devices? Both equal?
No, it's definitely Android more. I'd say a split of about 80-20 or 75-25. So 75 would be Android, 25% would be Apple. Yeah.
Great, Jinnah. Loved it. It's so inspiring to see, you know, startups realize their dreams, because this is what we need in today's day and age, because everybody is going through the mental health is a big thing. And, you know, I think you're fab job. Keep it up. Keep up the good work. And we are proud to have you as one of our top 100 leaders. That's amazing.